officers of Abia State origin and those living and doing business in the state on the current security situation. Dear brothers and sisters, the security situation in the state in the past few days, which led to the deployment of soldiers into our state ahead of the Operation Python Dance 2, has become of great concern to both government and the citizenry. After several interventions, I want to inform you that by tomorrow morning, there will be gradual withdrawal of soldiers from the streets of Aba and Omaha, apart from the pre-existing military checkpoints at various locations in the state, originally designed to curb kidnapping, armed robbery, and other violent crimes. With the expected exit of the soldiers from the streets, we must warn that we will not tolerate agitators and protesters taking over streets for any reason at all. I will also be meeting the President and Commander-in-Chief of the Armed Forces, President Muhammadu Buhari, to discuss possible ways of relaxing the Operation Python Dance 2 or Ekweke in the state for now. Our attention have been drawn to the ugly incidences of attacks on police stations and military posts at Aba, Omaha, and other locations. We hereby warn that we will no longer tolerate that and all other acts that are capable of causing insecurity of any form within the state. We have also observed illegal acts of throwing petrol bombs and setting up a bonfire to obstruct free movement along some roads by suspected miscreants, and wish to warn that such acts should stop forthwith. To mischief makers who want to use Abia State as their base, let me announce to you that henceforth, Abia will be too hot for you to carry out your wicked acts, as government will work with security agents to ensure the protection of lives and properties in the state without fear or favor. There will be no hiding place for you after this moment. At about midnight yesterday, we received security reports that hoodlums and miscreants, some of whom were allegedly brought into the state by unscrupulous individuals, were mobilizing around Orata Road at Aba with a view of converting at the international market to burn it down. Their aim was to obviously take advantage of the security situation in the state to cripple the economy of the state and cause widespread suffering. It was this group that originated the rumors of attacks and counter-attacks around the area, and also tried to create panic to force people out of their homes to enable them to execute their evil intentions under the cover of the orchestrated crisis. Thankfully, their plan was nipped to the board by a combined team of soldiers and policemen that promptly moved to the area and later positioned around the area market to protect the lives and properties of our people. We have it on good authority that the same group of hoodlums attempted to burn down the police station at the area market today, as security agents are currently on the hunt for them, and those outside the state who are sponsoring their evil actions will also be met to the full weight of the law. Not even one of them will escape the full weight of the law at the fullness of time. Members and sympathizers of the indigenous people of Biafra IPOB should henceforth desist from spreading false rumors capable of throwing our state into disorder. Those spreading such falsehoods will be dealt with according to the law. My fellow Abians, it is in the interest of our citizens and residents for full and total peace and security to return to our state immediately. No meaningful progress can be made in an atmosphere of violence and anarchy. Those that are back are therefore advised to fully observe the current curfew in the city and ensure that they cooperate with security agents to maintain peace and order. I swore to protect lives and properties of all Abians and residents, and I must do so even now. I therefore call on all to support our efforts at making sure that the lasting peace prevails in our dear state. God bless Abia State. God bless the Federal Republic of Nigeria.